A research repository is a central place where user research data is stored. This allows it to be accessible not only to the team that conducted the research, but also to others in the organization, such as other teams and stakeholders. Having a research repository in place can boost UX maturity because it can make insight about users more accessible to others in the organization. However, setting up a user research repository is not easy. Many UX practitioners struggle to convince their teams to adopt one. In this video, I'll cover three things to consider if you're thinking about creating one. Number one, choose the tool for your repository carefully. The tool you choose can drastically affect adoption. Now, there are different choices when it comes to tools for research repositories. Collaboration platforms that you may already have in place in your organization are the most popular. These include platforms like SharePoint and Confluence. Another popular option is user research platforms. If you have researchers and designers analyzing their data in a tool like Dovetail or Enjoy HQ, this can be a natural place to house your repository. The third option, which is popular in some teams, is database tools like Notion and Airtable. When choosing a tool, consider who needs to access it and their familiarity with the tool. Procuring a new tool that is unfamiliar could backfire, especially if you haven't got a solid plan for onboarding and change management. The second thing to think about is the format in which user research is going to be stored in your repository. Some repositories are searchable collections of atomic insights or findings, while other repositories are document libraries where research reports are stored. Of course, your repository could include both formats. Before deciding on a format, consider what would be most helpful to the people looking for research insight and how teams doing research document their learnings. The third item, which is somewhat related to our second, is to consider how user research will end up in the repository. Will you ask researchers and designers to upload reports, complete a short summary template, or extract, add, and tag insights to your repository? The more work you ask people to do to contribute, the greater the risk that they won't. Ideally, the contribution process should be a natural extension of the current process for reporting research. UX professionals who have succeeded in getting good adoption have done three things. One, they've researched with the people who would use it. This includes people who would contribute to it and those who would access it to find user research insight. Two, they've started small, been flexible, and iterated based on feedback. And three, they've had dedicated people who own the repository and are responsible for auditing contributions, onboarding new teammates, and socializing it. Setting up a research repository is a big task and shouldn't be underestimated. Do your research, make a plan, and be ready to adapt to the needs of your users.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more of our UX videos, take a look at these over here and consider subscribing to our channel. On our website, nngroup.com, you can access our free library of over 2,000 articles. You can also register for one of our UX courses that offer live, hands-on UX training.